This program is over to see the look at that videotape and Mr. Ellering.
I'd excuse you, but you're excusable anyway.
Mr. Ellering, I have a question for you, sir. It was a little difficult to tell on the monitor, but it certainly appeared to me that you had a very firm grasp on Ronnie Garvin's foot, which stopped him from possibly kicking out of a pinning combination.
Excuse me. You know, we always get real nice out here when we talk to you and we try to conduct ourselves like gentlemen. But you're the kind of guy that doesn't deserve to be treated like a gentleman. You sit here and you tell me or tell anybody else that you're just trying to push Ronnie Garvin's feet back in the rings. Feet back in the ring. You got that smug look.
Listen
all the
here,
time.
Ole Anderson, I've given you credit in the past for listening to intelligent people like you're doing right now. That's what you do best. You do best by listening. You went into retirement and then you come out of retirement and the people go, yeah, for the old man. You're an old man. I don't know if you wrestle or if that's what you do. You sure flap your jaws enough. You're like the Moby Dick of wrestling. You're always spouting off. And you talk about my Road Warriors. You say, oh yeah, precious Paul. You stand behind the Road Warriors. Well, I don't stand behind anybody. I'm out there by myself. I make things happen. And the Road
Warriors.
You
don't stand behind anybody. You stand behind everybody. You stand behind Snake. You're behind the Road Warriors. You're the one that's the reason for people getting beat, people getting hurt. Can you really say without any fear of contradiction
Listen
that you're...
Listen here, Ole Anderson. Let's carry on an intelligent conversation. I'll talk and you listen. You hear? I, in my magnanimous ways, have seen fit to bring nothing
There's
but the
nothing
best of world championship wrestling.
There's nothing about you that I like.
Listen
There's nothing
here,
that the people
Ole
like.
Anderson.
Why don't you listen for a second? I get tired of listening to you, too. These people right here, everybody at home, people in the arenas, they listen to you, they see you, and they just don't like you.
It just eats at you so bad, don't... No. It just eats at
I'm
your
I'm not talking
craw,
for me.
That
I'm
I have
talking...
all the champions, that I have the Road Warriors, that I have Jake the Snake. I have them all, and now I got the Sheik. I got everybody under contract. It doesn't matter. Buzz Sawyer's talking about here. Buzz Sawyer's talking about this. Well, even Buzz Sawyer, and if it comes down to that, Ole Anderson, from Tommy Rich to Buzz Sawyer to Pez Wiley, it don't matter who it is. If you're still left at the end of it all, I hope they save a little bit because I want to take you apart piece by piece.
You're so full of garbage, you stink.
Well,
you know when
I'll
we talk
you
about
what, gentlemen,
how
I hate to say this, but our time
you're nothing
is gone.
But a windbag
so
and an
long.
Old windbag.